also love, I love sleep so much, and I love sleep talking, right? I'm fascinated with it, I love it. And when I was about 19, I had a boyfriend, whatever, stop bringing it up. I'm just normal, guys, I'm just normal. And I would sleep beside him sometimes. Now, if there was something I was too nervous to talk to him about, I would bring it up with him by pretending to talk about it in my sleep. Yeah, now, some of you are thinking, that is the most manipulative thing I have ever heard. And some of you are thinking, that's brilliant. I've never met anyone else who's done it. Once a woman went, I've done that. She hadn't. What she'd been doing was way worse. She had been waiting for her partner to fall asleep, and then she would whisper shit to him. Just trying to subliminal message him. What a bucket of crazy. Can you think of anything creepier than waiting for your partner to fall asleep and be like, darling, darling, oh, good, you're asleep. Oh, you're sleeping. Oh, deep sleep. Buy me presents. Put the shelves up. You hate anal. You hate it. You hate it. Okay, that's close to home. All right, no, that's not what I was doing. Well, here's how it went down, right? So you go to bed, good night, kiss, kiss, roll over. You have to throw in a bit of gibberish at the start to make it believable, obviously. You know, give it a bit of, oh, Abraham Lincoln. No, I don't want any more strudel. Whatever. Have fun with it. And then we get to the beef of the situation, which was usually something like, I don't want to go to your reunion. And then the next day, I'd be like, I slept weird. I slept really weird. Did I talk in my sleep? He's like, yeah, you said you didn't want to go to the reunion. I was like, did I? That's weird. Because I totally want to go to your reunion with you. I absolutely want to drive you into the middle of nowhere and watch you get drunk with your friends who I don't like. I was really looking forward to that. Gosh, did I say I didn't want to go? Then maybe subconsciously, it's not a good idea. And this went on for a little while until one night we went to bed, good night, kiss, kiss, roll over. From his side of the bed, I hear a bit of, oh, wheelbarrow, chicken wire. He'd figured it out. And rather than confront me about it, he was giving it a go. What a legend. What an absolute champion. I would have high-fived him if he wasn't pretending to be asleep. I was that impressed. And this is what he gave it, right? He went, no, no. I don't want to go to your mum's birthday dinner. And then the next day, he was like, I slept weird. I slept really weird. Did I talk in my sleep? And I was like, no. Out like a light. You were. So mum's picking us up at 6 and she wants you to wear a suit. Love you. Thank you very much for having me, Montreal. It's been a pleasure.